Don't worry, you have come to the right channel. Hello, and welcome my friends to my YouTube channel, philippospan. Weekly tips and tricks on how to work with Microsoft Office applications. Today's video will be about Microsoft Word.
How to insert an endnote in a Microsoft Word document. An endnote can be a comment, an explanation, or a reference which is located at the end of a document or the section of a document that provide explanatory comments and contain reference information about the quoted material that would not interrupt the flow of the main text by moving upwards and downwards in the document. The endnotes are indicated by superscript numbers located next to the text and at the end of the document or section of a document. Stay tuned to find out how to insert an endnote in a Microsoft Word document. Before we select the command, we must locate our cursor next to the text that we want to insert our footnote, for example, here. Then we select the reference tab and locate the area of the ribbon named footnotes. If we hover over the command insert endnote, we are notified with the following. Insert endnote. Add a note like a comment or citation providing more info about something in your document. Superscript numbers referring to endnotes are added to your text. Once we select the insert endnote command, a superscript number will appear and will be placed next to the text that we want to immediately, and we will be transferred at the end of the document where the endnote will appear. The endnote is here, where at the last page of our document, for this example, number 56 page, next to the superscript number that indicates the endnote at the end of the document, we type in the information that we need. If we hover over the superscript number in our document, let's move to the first page. Here, we can see, we'll be able to see what we typed in the endnote while hovering over the superscript number in our document. If we insert another endnote in the document, the level of the numbering of the superscript will change also. I've moved my cursor next to this letter, this word, insert endnote. With once again transferred to the last page, the numbering has changed the level. Radio therapy. So we have one endnote, two endnotes. We can move to the previous endnote. We can move to the next endnote. Show notes. And we're once again transferred to the first page. One endnote which mentions Thessaloniki. Another one which mentions radiotherapy. If we want to modify the format of the endnotes or the location, we must select once again the reference tab. And from the area of the ribbon named footnotes, we select the arrow located at the bottom right corner here, and the footnote and endnote dialog box will appear. In this dialog box, we can modify the following, but first we must activate the checkbox to make sure that we're going to modify the endnotes, as shown, as we can see here. Endnotes. Where do we want the location of the endnotes? End of document, end of section. End of document. Here we do not touch it because it's got to do with the footnote layout. We can change the format of the endnotes. Now they are Latin characters. We can change it 1, 2, 3, ABC small, ABC capital, and etc. We can change where from which number it's going to start from. We can change the numbering if it's going to be continuous or restart at each section. And we can apply changes to the selected section, or the whole document. Whatever adjustments we do, we just press the apply button located at the bottom right corner of the footnote and endnote dialog box. I am just going to press cancel. So an endnote looks like a footnote. Here we are. An endnote looks like a footnote, but the major difference is that the endnotes are located at the end of the document or the section of the document.
Thank you all for watching. If you have enjoyed what you saw in this video, please subscribe to my channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free and let me know by heading down to the comment section.